Good morning, students. Welcome back to Alchemy Online class. This is Nikita Barik. So I really hope you all are fit, fine and healthy, and curiously you all are waiting to open, to get this lockdown to be open same way. Even I'm waiting for it. I want to meet you all. But see, Alchemy school has given us a great opportunity by starting this Alchemy Online class. You can easily sit and learn from your home. No need to go somewhere else. Just swipe and just watch all the videos, whichever subject you want to watch. Regular basis, all the subject teachers are posting their videos. You can easily go through all the subjects, so you don't need to worry about your studies. So in today's video, what we are going to study, any guesses? We are going to study about nouns. What is a noun, or I can say, what are nouns? What are the types of noun that we are going to study in today's video? What is a noun? Let's talk about what is a noun. A noun is a naming word that names a person, place, animal or thing. One more thing I want to add it in this. Noun can be in a singular form as well as it can be in a plural form. Now, what is singular and what is plural form? Singular means single thing. That is, a quantity will be only in single. That is only one. More than one, if anything is going or any person is there or any animal is there, then we call it as in a plural form. To study detail in it, I have made a video for you all so that you will be very clear with the topic, that is singular, what is singular and what is plural form. Let's have a look. See students, I have got one bangle. So bangle, but when I'm putting so many bangles over here, then answer is bangles. So bangle, bangles. This one cup kept on the bed. So cup, but when I'm keeping two cup, so cups. So cup, cups. One glass, so glass. And more than one, that's two are kept, so answer is glasses. Glass, glasses. Got it students? See students, I've got one feather. So feather, and answer will be, if I have to make it in plural form, plural means more than one. So more than one feather, let's bring it out. Feathers. So answer is feathers. Feather and feathers. Now see students, there's a book over here. So book, and more than one book, that is plural form as books. So book and book. Can you see student? Can you see student, there's one coin. So coin, singular form is coin. But if I have more than one coin, then it's coins. Yeah, absolutely right. Plural form of coin is coins. Now see students, there's a pen. So pen, and more than one pen, that's plural form of pen will be, one pen is singular form. So plural form is pens. Can you see, lot of pens are kept. So pen and pens.
So students, I really hope now you are very clear with what is singular form and what is plural form. Moving further, we are going to study about what are the types of nouns. So the first type today that we are going to study is common noun. So in common noun, what happens is, a common noun refers to a person or thing. Okay, no specification will be given. For example, if I am saying a boy is laughing, did I mention the name of the boy? I didn't. I simply said a boy is laughing. So the boy is a noun. Which type of noun it is? It is a common noun. One more example I want to give you all. I live in a city. Which city? Did I mention the name of the city? No, I didn't say anything. I simply said I live in a city. You don't know the name of my city now. So what it is? City is a noun, but which type of noun it is? It is a common noun. If I say lots of flowers are grown in the garden, but which flowers I'm talking about, do you all know? No, you all don't know which flowers I'm talking about. So what it is? It is a common noun. Now clear? What is common noun? That does not give you any kind of specification. It's, we talk it in a very general manner. Got it? Moving further to the second type of noun, that is proper noun. So whenever specification is given about person, place or thing, we call it as a proper noun. Let me give you an example. India is my country. See here students, I gave you the specification that which is my country? India. So here I'm giving you the specification. So India is which type of noun? It is a proper noun. Got it? Got the difference? See, when I'm saying I live in a country, which country do I live in? Did I mention? No. When I'm not mentioning it, it is a common noun. But where I'm mentioning that I live in, that is India is my country. So which country do I stay? I stay in country India. So India is which type of noun? It is a proper noun. Second example I want to give you is Rita is dancing. The name is mentioned over here. Which name? Rita. So what? Which type of noun it is? It is a proper noun. So whenever specification is given to you, it is a proper noun. When specification is not given, then it is a common noun. Moving further to the next type of noun is collective noun. See students, the word itself suggests collective. Collective means collection, or I can say group. Group of what? Group of people, group of animals, or group of things. All this group, when it is used as a word, that word is called as collective noun. See, for example, if I have only one ant is there, then which article I'll use? An ant. But when there's a collection, that is 50 ants, then which word I'll use? I'll use an army of ants. Only this collective word, that collective noun word we are using, we call it as collective noun, to represent a group or to represent a collection. More example, let's see. A flock of sheep, a flock of birds, a herd of deer, a litter of puppies, a swarm of bees, and so on. So many words are also there. And I'll be also giving you a slide so that you can easily solve the exercise that I'm going to give you for the collective noun. So are you clear? In collective noun, we study or we talk about collection or group of number of people or animals or things. See, I've used people, animals or things, no place. Okay, so people, animals or thing, collection or group, we call it as collective noun. Now see students, I have got three exercises for you that you can solve it easily at your home by learning through my slides that I'll be providing you, okay, for collective noun. So the first exercise that we have is unscramble the words and write the collective noun for each groups given below. A dash of elephants. See, a group of elephant is given to you. So what that group we call it is, if it's a group of elephant, there's a particular word. Yes. Herd, a herd of elephants. One more example, a dash of puppies, a litter of puppies, and so on. Few more sentences are given to you and that you have to solve it out. Rest you will do by yourself. Okay, next exercise is fill in the blanks with suitable words from the box. Already clue box is given to you. From that you have to find it out that which is suitable word for the particular sentence. Okay, let's have a look. And dash of ants lived under the log. We already studied a group of ant is there. Then what name is given to them? An army of ants. Got it? So what will be the answer? Army. See students, third exercise is about there are 12 collective nouns in the word grid. Find them. There's a grid given to you. In that you have got 12 collective nouns that you have to find it and you have to highlight it. Got it? All these three exercises I'll be providing you and try to solve it by yourself at your home. And one more slide I'll be giving you so that you can easily go through the collective noun and can do this exercise at home. Okay, that's all for the day today. Thank you. Have a nice day.